we have some special guests. We have Eliza and Norah and Meredith. We are glad you're here today. Could you lead us in Jesus' greatest commandments?
To love God with all of our hearts, with all of our minds, and with all of our souls, and to love our neighbors as ourselves.
That is right. That is Jesus' greatest commandments. Now, we are in the very long season after Pentecost. Eliza, could you point to where the season after Pentecost is? That's right, it's right there. And during the season after Pentecost, we grow in our Christian faith, and it is also called another, it has another name. Do you know the other name of the season after Pentecost?
Ordinary time.
Norah, impressive. Yes, it is ordinary time. And so today's story comes from one of our four gospels. Do we know our four gospels? Yes, Eliza.
Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
Excellent. Yes, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Eliza, I know you know where Matthew is in the Bible bookshelf. Could you pull it out and show the kids at home? Great. All right. So it starts off our New Testament. Thank you for pulling that out. All right. So the Gospel of Matthew teaches us all about the way God wants us to live in the world as Jesus' disciples and how we treat our neighbor. And it also tells us the story of Jesus' birth, life, and ministry, death, and resurrection. So there's a lot in the Gospel of Matthew. Now, today's story is about a woman who really, really, really loves her daughter. Now, Norah, Eliza, could you stand up?
Yes.
Okay. Could you imagine someone that you really, really love? You kids at home do the same thing. Stand up and imagine someone you really, really love. And can you stretch out your arms wide as if you were going to give that person a hug? That's pretty wide. Could you stretch it out even wider? Whoa, that's really, really wide. Okay, excellent. So, this woman really, really loved her daughter and stretched herself in her encounter with Jesus to help her sick daughter. Now, in this story, and from the Gospel of Matthew, we've got this map, and Jesus and his disciples were north of the area called, can you read that, Norah?
Galilee.
So they were north of that area. And they came across a woman named, we don't have a name for her, but she was the Canaanite woman. And the Canaanite woman loved her daughter. Her daughter was very, very ill. And when she encountered Jesus, she said, "Lord, have mercy on me. My daughter is very sick, and I know you can heal her." Now, the disciples just wanted to leave. But Jesus stayed and listened. But they were kind of surprised. They were all surprised that the Canaanite woman was calling out to Jesus. Because the Canaanite people didn't really, most of them didn't believe in God. So they were surprised at her faith. So she kept repeating, "Jesus, have mercy, heal my daughter." And Jesus finally did. He said, you have shown so much faith that I will heal your daughter. So that woman, that Canaanite woman, showed her faith and Jesus showed mercy. Now, do you like at home word jumbles? Norah, do you like a word jumble?
Yes.
Eliza, have you done a word jumble before?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Let's try to figure out these word jumbles and the words that we will that would be the solution are the themes of our story of the Canaanite woman. All right, so here's your first jump. Ready? I'm going to lay out the, actually, let me give you the letters. And why don't you lay them out and try on the floor and try to solve the word jumble. You kids at home, try to solve alongside with Norah and Eliza.
The letters are T, F, A, I, and H.
That's right. Offering to those in